enjoy the time as well. Today is a day of real celebration, and I can say with complete certainty that we are delighted to be here. In fact, we've been delighted to be part of your entire journey that has brought you here to this point. I know that today marks the culmination of months and of years of dedicated work, effort, and determination, and commitment. And it is right and proper that we recognise your great achievements. You have worked hard to complete your programme and everything that went along with it. The lectures, the seminars, the reading, the assignments, the assessments, the work placements, the presentations and exams, you don't need me to rhyme through them all. And really importantly, all of those engagements with your peers. As a consequence of successfully completing your programme, you have now acquired the skills, the ideas, and the critical thinking to make a difference in whatever field you're planning to go into. Please don't underestimate the ability you have to make an impact. And don't underestimate how important a role you have to play in the future of your sector and to us all in this place. If you take one thing away with you today, please let it be this: the knowledge you have everything that you need to succeed in whatever it is you want to do next. That might be continuing with studying, to undertake research, to take up employment, embark on a new career opportunity, even to start your own work. Because you have what it takes. You have the qualification, you have the skills, and you've now gained the status of an Ulster University, or the status of an Ulster University graduate, and what that means to businesses and organisations. I hope and trust that Ulster University has given you the ambition, the aspiration, and the confidence in your ability and your potential to go on and do what you want to do. Because that confidence in you, by everybody else, is already out there. Graduation today means so much to us at Ulster University. Those of us here today on this stage and those who have supported you throughout, because we know how hard you have worked to get here. And we know the potential that you have. I know that that can sound daunting, so I want to take some inspiration from this date. On this day, 12th of December, 42 years ago, the company Apple launched on the US stock market, and as we know, has become a household name, one of the most important and influential companies there has ever been. Of course, founded by Steve Jobs, he said something that has inspired me. He said, "Your time is limited, so don't waste it living someone else's life." I can identify with that completely. And I think it's something important that, particularly at this stage of your career, to embrace. That actually, if you aspire in your work and in the rest of your life to be like someone else, it might be someone who you hold in very high esteem. It might be somebody that the world knows who's achieved a huge amount. All you'll be destined to do and be is in a mould of them. You'll only ever be as good as them. If you believe in destiny, what if you were destined to do something else? What if you were destined to do something greater and more important. But I've tried to learn, and it's hard, is that to use yourself as your benchmark, not someone else. To actually look at the work that you've done the day before and see, how can I improve on that? And start each day trying to develop from where you left off the last day. The world doesn't need another person who already exists. The world needs you. He also said, Steve Jobs also said, don't be trapped by dogma, which is living with the results of other people's thinking. Don't let the noise of others' opinions drown out your own inner voice. And most important, have the courage to follow your heart and intuition. Be bold, be brave, be determined. As the author Roy T. Bennett wrote, you're braver than you think, more talented than you know, and more capable of more than you imagine. I think I can speak for everyone in the audience today when I say, believe in yourself because we believe in you. That is true of all of us here at Ulster, but it is even more true for those who've come with you today, your family and friends. I know how thrilled they are at your success, how excited they are to see you walk across the stage, and how much belief they have in your ability to do whatever you set your mind to. I want to take a moment just to thank all of the mums and dads, husbands, wives, partners, sons, daughters, sisters, brothers, grandparents. Don't worry, I'm not going to rhyme through them all. Everyone who has supported you during your time here. I'm sure many of them played a crucial part in getting you here with kind words of encouragement, perhaps at times stern words of motivation, cups of coffee or tea, or generally just being there, doing whatever you needed them to do. I know all of our graduates appreciate everything you have done for them, and we all want to say thank you. So perhaps the graduates and everybody else can show our gratitude to the people who have supported you with a round of applause. Hands up if that's the first time you've actually been thanked. A few hands there, yep. Today is, of course, a momentous personal milestone marking the conclusion of your program here at Ulster. But this is not the end. Although many of you have left the university campus, you are not leaving the Ulster University network. You are now part of a vibrant, welcoming, supportive, and inspiring Ulster University alumni community. I hope you will continue to keep in touch with us and take advantage of the full range of benefits, events, opportunities we provide for you, our graduates. We also know that your career stories will inspire those who follow you through the corridors of this university. So please stay in touch. We actually love to hear about the success which you bring to your lives. You leave behind so much for current and future students to be inspired by. The success and accomplishment that will empower them and their ability to achieve. Do not underestimate that and the impact you are already having in the world. For now, let me conclude with the words of renowned educationalist Michael Josephson. Take pride in how far you've come, Have faith in how far you can go, but don't forget to enjoy the journey. So, enjoy your day today. And on behalf of us all, congratulations again. Thank you. So, in accordance with the wishes of the Senate, and by virtue of the authority vested in me, I confer honorary degrees, degrees, and other academic distinctions of the University of Ulster on those named in the conferment list approved by the Senate. I now call upon Professor McElfatrick, Dean of the Ulster Doctoral College, to present candidates.
Chancellor, in the name of Senate, I present to you candidates for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Arts, Humanities and Social Sciences, Paul McQueen. Lauren Helen Bell. The degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Life and Health Sciences, Justin McLaughlin. Nicole Marie Miller. Emma Nolan. Carlene Walsh. The degree of Doctor of Medicine, Jonathan Andrew Mealy. The degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Business and Management, Gemma Faith. Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of candidates from the Ulster Doctoral College.
Thank you, Professor McElfatrick, for presenting candidates. I call upon Professor Connolly, Executive Dean of the Faculty of Arts, Humanities and Social Sciences, to present candidates.
Chancellor, in the name of Senate, I present to you candidates for the degree of Master of Arts in English Literature. Emily Maeve Gavigan. Peter John Linkins. Jack Lyons. Kira O'Rourke. Katie Bell. The degree of Master of Arts in History, Hannah Brown. Rebecca Brown. Paul Callan. Hannah Rebecca Carlisle. Nicholas John Hatton. Katie Georgina Johnston. Jordan Louise Lennon. Clodagh Maria Skeffington. Sarah Matthew Connolly. Callum Doherty. Michael Anthony McMillan. Faith Jane Greer Cochran. Amy Jackson. The degree of Master of Arts in Journalism, Andrew Balfour. Matthew Fox. Jonathan Heron. Scott Mann. Emma Jane Montgomery. Aaron Rice. Gabrielle Swan. Leah Karen Cunningham. Olivia Paige Elsie. Luke Hutchinson. Joshua Peter Andrew Murray. Matthew O'Hara. Clodagh Traynor. Rebecca Frances Parker. The degree of Master of Arts in Teaching of English to Speakers of Other Languages, Corina Lorraine Hansen Clegg. Neve Gamble. Rachel O'Neill. Jude Reddy. Grace Bethany Carson. And the Postgraduate Diploma in Teaching of English to Speakers of Other Languages, Mary Kate Johnson. Postgraduate Certificate in Education in Art and Design, Sinead Claire McCafferty. The Postgraduate Certificate in Education in Music, Dylan Thomas Lennox. The Postgraduate Certificate in Education in Primary Education, Hannah Catherine Cairns. The degree of Bachelor of Arts with Honours in English, Emma Rose Collins. Chloe Ellen Hindman. Curtis Lynn. Tim McKay. Holly Porter. The degree of Bachelor of Arts with Honours in English with Education, Molly Curley. The degree of Bachelor of Arts with Honours in History, Brona Catherine Hayes. Michael Hugh Alexander Irvine. Harvey McClurkine. Melissa Rebecca Murphy. Aaron Ian Hannah. The degree of Bachelor of Arts of Honours in Journalism with English, Bernadette Connolly. The degree of Bachelor of Science with Honours in Interactive Media and Diploma in Professional Practice, Lucy Hannah Fleming. Stephen Robert Jack McCallan. William Quigley. The degree of Bachelor of Science with Honours in Interactive Media, Anya Doherty. Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of candidates for the Faculty of Arts, Humanities and Social Sciences.
Thank you, Professor. I call upon Professor Curran, Executive Dean of the Faculty of Life and Health Sciences, to present candidates.
Chancellor, in the name of the Senate, I present to you candidates for the degree of Master of Pharmacy, Amy O'Hora. Saoirse Eilish Currid. The degree of Master of Research in Life and Health Sciences, Elspieta Marta Krasson Kidzinska. Connor Donnell. The degree of Master of Science in Advanced General Dental Practice, Rami Alaham. Gina Koduvath Jacob. Faimitha Pani Cavito. Rika Sasi Kumar. Vishnu Kartik. Anju Maria. Neethu Abraham Raju. Ahmed Aladji. Manal Ansari. Simna Anthony. Ashwathi Balakrishnan. Rohith Balakrishnan Nair. Anushka Bhatia. Rio Matthew Kirayath Athanikal. Akshay Dharam. Elben Eldo Edison. Alina Francis. Rosemary Onyinyi Gatter. Ninu George. Sheba Anna George. Sabina Hansen. Anand Thakrishnan Hari Krishnan. Anne Jacob. Suruthe Jayasri. Sinha Lisbeth Gigi. Amala Rose John. Sabitha Nana Kazial John. Conchita Jolly. Janet Jose. Rose Mary Jose. Anu Joseph. Surya Mal Joseph. Bebeto Joseph Raju. Nandu Sasidar Kolambala. Mega Kumanthude. Niha Koshby. Hari Krishna Konath Faz. Kritika Sanjeev Mahajan. Anne Mariam Mamen. Leah Savio Manatu. Anilda Manikato Alias. Nathan Matthew. Greshma Melbourne. Reshma Nair. Sanath Kumar Narendran Pillai. Kavya Prakash. Anjali Krishna Radhakrishnan. Sethu Lakshmi Rajev. Aswathi Ranjith Kumar. Raki Ravindran. Resmi Rejunada Kurupsanti. Shiba Rupesh. Anna Roy. Sachin Sam. Marilyn Samuel Cutty. Sally Santu. Priya Sasidharan Nair. Roshni Satisan. Sandhya Sandivel. Bennett Arumal Shaji. Amala Sibichan. Sidhai Starson. Dina Suzama Thomas. Albie Susan Abraham. Andrea Fanacott. Shannai Farah. Rosebin Thomas Abraham. Anita Thomas Manai. Afrin Tunde Parambil Nashad. Emmy Ann Tomei. Malavika Unai. Ashwarya Vikas. Priya John William. Sujan Debnath. Soria John. Sheroz Malik. Nina Shaju. The degree of Master of Science in Advanced Pharmacy Practice, Lindsay Alexander. Colette Flanagan. Stephanie Hawkey. Cecilia McAuleen. Roisin Maria McMenamin. Niall Patrick O'Kean. The degree of Master of Science in Clinical Oral Implantology, Ali Abdulmalik Varanai. The degree of Master of Science in Clinical Periodontics, Timothy David Phillips. The degree of Master of Science in Facial Aesthetics, Justina Augustate. Romina Elena Maikula. Abhinash Korbasin. Abdul Reza Paksad. Ellen Ann Pettigrew. Muhammad Tayab. The degree of Master of Science in Geographic Information Systems, Oliver Bradley. Sarah Rose Duff. Rosie Kate Durham. Wada Ishmael Mahmood. James Rowett. Rebecca Smith. Grace Una Cooper. Eva Rachel Hare. Catriona Ann Nolan. Aaron Rossbotham. The degree of Master of Science in Pharmaceutical Sciences, Michaela Michael. Fatima Shorna. Opiyami Christiana Jagadi. Edward Adibuwali Mitiko. Hussein Mohammed Reza. The Postgraduate Certificate in Environmental Management with Geographic Information Systems, Sarah Victoria Smith. The degree of Master of Science in Pharmaceutical Biosciences, Victoria Pollyanne Fullerton Bungay. Connor Tasker Lynch. Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of candidates from the Faculty of Life and Health Sciences.
Thank you, Professor. I now call upon Professor Durkin, Executive Dean of the Ulster University Business School, to present candidates.
Chancellor, in the name of the Senate, I present to you candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science with Honours in Consumer Management and Food Innovation and Diploma in Professional Practice, Ella Carroll. The degree of Bachelor of Science with Honours in International Travel and Tourism Management, Rachel Branigan. Jack Earle. Mary Margaret Hanvey. Kerry McCracken. Tammy Lee Corrigan. Emily Danielle MacIver. Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of candidates from the Ulster University Business School.
Thank you, Professor. I now call upon Matt Fox, a new graduate in the Faculty of Arts, Humanities and Social Sciences, to propose a vote of thanks. Thank you.
Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, academic staff, fellow graduates, ladies, gentlemen, and all those in between, family and friends, I am honoured to speak to you on behalf of those graduating here today. In Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas, Hunter S. Thompson famously wrote, "When the going gets weird, the weird get professional." Well, the going got very weird a couple of years ago with the arrival of COVID-19, and some of us, myself included, took a moment to reassess our lives. Before the pandemic, I was working in hospitality, a job that I wholeheartedly believe everybody should do at least once. I had some media experience from my undergraduate studies, but I wasn't using it and felt that I'd missed my chance. During the lockdown, my housemate Rebecca and I had started a podcast discussing our lived experiences growing up in Northern Ireland. It was soon on iTunes, and while we mainly started it to pass the time, it finally gave us a legitimate excuse to drink whiskey and talk about 90s music. I'd like to thank her for dusting off my digital skills and inspiring me to reconsider education. So, within months, I'd applied and been accepted to the Master's Journalism programme here at Ulster. I'd like to personally thank Dr. Murphy and Maggie Swarbrick for giving me an opportunity after what I thought was a particularly ropey interview on Zoom. I'd also like to thank the university for awarding me a studentship through the Department for Economy. This allowed me to pay my fees, manage my bills, and focus solely on the degree programme. And so, at 30 years of age, and after 10 years away from academia, I began the daily train journey to Coleraine alongside hundreds of other keen, bright learners who immediately inspired me. The first semester was daunting for all of us, thrown out into the corridors interviewing students, recording ourselves on camera and audio, as well as intensive law and politics lectures, preparing for NCTJ examinations within a matter of weeks. No easy feat while also attempting to master shorthand, which I didn't quite do. The benefit of being taught by journalists is that they understand there's only so much teaching they could give us. On day one, we were told, "You are now reporters." Our coursework became our portfolio. Every interview and opportunity was encouraged. Every piece of professional studio equipment utilised, and by Christmas, several of us had already been published in newspapers across the country. This is undoubtedly because of our lecturers' professional experience and connections. The course and those that lead it is respected across this island, with dozens of household names having passed through these doors at one stage or another, many of whom then return to advise us through an engaging speaker series put forward by the Journalism School. By July, I was a freelancer. I had my work published on the front pages of the Belfast Telegraph and the Irish News 6 times, and I had just gained employment at BBC News, where I still am, having undertaken a work placement organised by this university. And all of this before starting a dissertation, which I really wouldn't recommend anyone. But with my supervisor's support, we got there in the end, and I'm proud to say that I have finished this course with a distinction, inclusion on the Dean's List, and the NUJ Award for Top Performance. I would not have achieved this. Thanks. I would not have achieved this without the unwavering commitment of my lecturers, Colm, Leona, Maggie, Anne, Gail, and Vincent, as well as the continued love and support from my parents, Carmel and Kevin. It has been a remarkable year, and although we were warned it would fly in, I don't think any of us truly realised how quickly we'd be working in newsrooms across the country. Remarkable too in the stories that we've been covering: the pandemic, the war in Ukraine, chaos at Westminster, the death of Queen Elizabeth, and on a local level, the ongoing cost of living crisis, elections and stalemates, a health service at breaking point, and the tragic gas explosion in Chrysler, County Donegal. I speak for every graduate here today in thanking the university for its dedication to not only education, but work placement and future employment. We all have very promising futures having studied here. The degree certificates that we have been presented with today signify the hard work, effort and dedication that each of us have made. The knowledge and attributes acquired through our studies at Ulster University will in turn shape and influence others in the very paths that each of us now will choose to take. On behalf of all graduates, I would like to thank the lecturers and support staff from the university for helping each of us succeed during our time here, even through particularly challenging circumstances. None of us could have anticipated the impact of the global pandemic on all aspects of society. Uni life was reshaped along with the rest of the world. And as we adapted our lives and learning, we are grateful for the dedication and commitment of those who enabled us to continue in our studies and keep our career ambitions on track. I'd also like to thank all the family and friends who have joined us in celebrating our successes here today. We are all incredibly lucky to have so many people champion us as we embark on the next stage of our lives. To my fellow graduates, congratulations. It has been a pleasure studying alongside you, and we should all be incredibly proud of our achievements. Thank you.
Matt, thank you for those inspiring words. You're quite right. You all can be very proud. So I declare this graduation ceremony closed and invite the new graduates to join the academic procession. Thank you.